Welcome to VTrum Tips. In this video, I want to introduce my custom eDrum set and explain it in detail. I will show you every part of it and tell you why I decided to use the respective gear. I call this setup an indie metal kit. As the right position is typical for an indie drum set, and the number of toms plus the double kick pedal gives it some metal features. I needed years to figure out a setup that is matching my drumming style. It somehow naturally evolved into this configuration. The drum shell diameters are 13 inch for the snare, 10, 12, 12 and 14 for the toms, and 20 for the kick drum. These shells are from a Pearl Rhythm Traveler set. I chose them because of the real size playing surface and their flatness, which is necessary to save space. It is supposed to be a big but also a compact apartment drum kit. A deep bass drum shell would simply take too much space. I made a video series about the build of these shells. Find the link of the A to E conversion series in the description below. The kit has three different kinds of mesh heads. A 2-ply DrumTech series mesh head for the snare and 3-ply Chobeki heads for toms and kick drum. The kick has a leftover 2-ply DrumTech mesh as a resonant head. The snare got a cheap 1-ply mesh as a resonant head too. Resonant mesh heads do really decrease the noise, so they are not just there for the looks. The room noise is actually the reason for me to go for quiet Chobeki drum heads for the toms. These open pads are simply too noisy with the DrumTech heads. So I had to compromise on the playing feel and the rebound to get the noise down. But this is actually okay, as for my toms I do not need a perfect rebound. The triggers inside those shells are my self-made torch triggers. They consist of R-Drum's piezos and trigger cones, as it is really important for me to have a Roland-like trigger response. The construction of these triggers itself is inspired by DrumTech, but slightly modified. You might ask yourself, why does the trigger have to look so complicated? Why does it need a mounting arm on every lug? This is necessary to have a rock-solid center that can resist the stick force and does not vibrate. To not cause unwanted triggering, these arms ensure that the rim piezo has the exact same distance to the drum rim at every rim spot. This is very important to have a consistent and accurate rim triggering, especially as a snare trigger. I would never use anything else for my snare drum. Roland, DrumTech and AllDrums build such trigger configurations for this exact reason. Other setups would work as well, but the question is, how good would they walk and how long do they last? The center triggered cone is also a must-have for higher end Roland modules, since those modules are providing positional sensing. This is a feature in which the module recognizes where you hit the drum pad and changes the sound accordingly. I love this feature, as it is something that makes the eDrum kit more realistic. These trigger cones are made out of a special foam that reacts faster than the old Roland cones and the cheap no-name trigger foams. This is necessary to use the full potential of the TD30 or TD50 module. I'm using these cones for over 2 years and they did not shrink a bit, which is usually something that you will experience with cheaper foams. The torch trigger is in every drum pad, except the big floor tom. This pad has my other trigger system called Flex Trigger 2.0. This system is even better than the torch trigger, as it is more steady and also flexible. It can be used for all shell sizes from 10 to 16 inch. Unfortunately, it is too much effort and too expensive to build these type of triggers. So I went with the other design, which is almost as good. The bass drum has the AllDrums RTB trigger bar. The system has one of the best bass drum trigger sensors. It is as sensitive as a Roland trigger, but the bar construction is not as good as the high-end AllDrums or Ronga kick triggers, as it misses the dampening ring. So my beaters are actually bouncing back and cause some unwanted triggering. I have fixed this in the module and just cancelled out the failed triggers. I do not even recognize them while playing, but the proper way to get rid of unwanted rebound would be one of those three systems. The cymbals are exclusively from Roland. I use 3 CY14 as crashes, 1 CY12 as a splash, a CY13 as China and the CY15 as ride cymbal. There is a very good reason why I'm only using Roland cymbals. They simply are the best eDrum cymbals you can get. They are durable, well engineered, they move realistically, their triggering is good and they are not too noisy. No other e-symbol can cope with that, which is related to Roland owning most of the e-symbol patents. My cymbals get the regular treatment with Dr. Keto, which is the best rubber cleaner for e-drums, in my experience. The other products are good, but simply not as good as this one. This little bottle lasts for years, and the fluid is all natural, so it does not smell like chemicals in your flat. The hire does not really fit in. It is a metallic gray Roland VH13. I should have kept my VH12, as it was black and the response is 100% as accurate as the VH13's response. The only downside of this hi-hat is the room noise emission. It is simply loud. But other than that, it is the best and most realistic e-drum hi-hat you can get. But keep in mind that the pressure feature is only working with TD12, 20, 30 and 50. Check my review in the video description if you want to know the differences between VH11, 12 and 13. The hi-hat stand is a second-hand DW9500 two-leg hi-hat stand. I bought it for a quarter of its sales price. It was dirty and cried for maintenance. I like that it matches my DW9000 pedals, but I would not have bought it new for 400 euro. I think there are hi-hat stands that have much more functions for a much better price, like the Tama HH905D or the Pearl H2050. The same applies to the DW9000 pedal. It is a very nice pedal with countless adjustment options. I own this pedal for 5 years now and it is very durable, except the drive shaft. But I would not have bought it if I would not have gotten it at a sale for half its price. A Pearl Eliminator pedal with nylon straps would have been my choice. I simply like to play this pedal, regardless of its price. Beaters you can see here are Altrum soft beaters. These are high quality stainless steel beaters with exchangeable beater heads. They reduce impact noise, but unfortunately Altrum does not make them at the moment. My alternative choice would be the Drumtech soft beater. Those beaters hit the Drumtech Protection.pro, a thick foam rubber beater patch that sticks like hell, but can be removed without leaving marks at the mesh head. Its main purpose is to protect the mesh head and the beaters from wear. All pedals and the hi-hat stand are placed on top of Roland noise eaters. Check out my review video to learn more about them. These boards do a great job with reducing impact noise. They are expensive but solid high quality products. I can totally recommend them to everyone that has kick pad noise problems. My second noise reducing solution is my DIY Silomare sound absorber platform. It is detachable to make it easy to transport. I made a video on how to build this monster. Find the link in the description. The drum rack is a modified Roland MDS-20 rack with cables inside the rack pipes and height adjustable legs. It consists of components from Go eDrums, Drumtech, Gibraltar and Pearl. This was a very big project that got documented in my longest video ever. I'm very petty about cables. Call me crazy, but I hate it when an eDrum kit looks dodgy through bad cable management. The cymbal mounts are from different Roland kits that I owned over the years. This rack is very compact if folded. Like everything, my drum rack has to be transportable. My favorite detail about this rack is this little K&M smartphone mount. I placed it on the right side of the kit to be able to play along to music from my phone. It is impossible to accidentally hit the phone there. The cable goes through the rack into the module. My headphones are mounted on a DIY Rest Pieces headphone mount. I'm using this Audio-Technica ATH M40X headphones. They cost around 100 euro, are very comfortable, solid and isolate well, which is important for e-drum kits, as you want to cancel out the actual pad noise. I bought them because of their neutral sound, as I need them not only for drumming, but also for mixing and recording. My drum set contains one percussion pad, the Roland BT1, which is the best trigger bar you can buy. It is very sensitive and can be mounted to a drum rim. Additional mounting gear is not necessary. I'm using this pad for cowbell sounds and rim clicks most of the time. And here is the heart of my e-drum set, my beloved Roland TT30. I got this module secondhand for a very good price, and it is a killer device. There is so much you can do with that module. It has endless inputs, features positional sensing, the sounds can be edited, and it has a USB port to connect it to a PC. I even created my own custom drum sound bundle with this module. By the way, I'm selling this bundle on my website to fund my projects. Find the link in the video description. The mix in volume knob is awesome to mix in music from my connected smart devices, and I like those analog instrument mixing sliders, which makes it possible to mix the instruments instantly. There's so much you can do with this module. It is unbelievable. I thought about buying a TD50, but at the moment this module has everything I need, except for the real samples, but therefore I have my good old Easy Drummer 2. My MacBook Pro can be connected via USB cable. I trigger Easy Drummer inside Logic Pro X for recording projects or as standalone to jam around with. The MacBook Pro was expensive, but it is worth every cent. I own it for 4 years and it helped me to create every single video for this channel. Easy Drummer 2 and recording software runs flawlessly. There is no latency issue either and no ASUX driver needed. There are still some things I want to change on this kit. This Duel is a really cheap no-name drum drone that is not only uncomfortable, but makes me sweat at places where the sun doesn't shine, so it has to be exchanged. The snare stand is okay, but not great. I want to have a snare stand that has kind of an overhang, to place it a bit away from the noise eaters, since the legs of the snare stand have no space there. And finally, my rack will get a laptop mount. That's it for my drum kit tour. I just want to point out that almost every component of this drum set is used. Only some components are new. I would not have such a setup if I was buying all these parts brand new. My channel would not even exist, cause I would not have to fix or clean things. So secondhand gear is actually great. If you want to see a playing example, click on the sound package video. But keep in mind, it is an advertisement video for my custom drum sounds. Thanks for watching and please let me know if you like these setup videos. Tell me if you're interested in the video production gear that I'm using to make these videos. Find all video and product links in the video description. That's it for today and see you next time.